Good morning. Good morning to everyone present here. It's an immense pleasure for me to welcome you all for this guest lecture. So I would like to thank Mr. Praveen Kumar, the guest speaker for today's session. So for taking the time out of his busy schedule and have come here to give you a real-time exposure about how the software is being used in postal technology. So, students, I want you to make use of this session. I would like to call upon Mr. Praveen Kumar to take away the session.
Good morning, good morning all. I thank the management and the organizers for giving me this opportunity. So, let me share my screen. Is my screen visible?
Yes, yes, Praveen. Yes, it's visible.
Yeah. Okay. So today I will start with the introduction about myself and then about my organization. So what do we do? And then as a brief, we can see about the system requirement specification document that is part of software engineering course. Okay, so let me start. So myself, I am Praveen Kumar. I have completed my ME in Systems Engineering and Operations Research. So I have been working in worked in three different organizations, NIPMET Chennai, and then Amazon, and then currently I am working in Department of Post in Center for Excellence in Postal Technology. I also co-authored a book on web development, and I do guest lectures like this. In some colleges or universities, okay, and I am a learner too. I keep learning new things. Okay, so that is a short brief about myself. So let me tell you about postal department. So postal department is more than 160 years old. It is the first post office actually started in 1774 in Calcutta. As a department, it is now 160 years old totally. So postal department, our India Post, is actually world's largest postal network. It has around 155,000 post offices around India. Okay, you can find any, we are having pin code set everywhere. There is a pin code, and so wherever pin code is there, it is it means that postal department is there, and there is no place in India without pin code. Right, so what do postal department do? Postal department means we will just think about letters, right? But that's not the yeah. So postal department means mostly we will get an image of letter or parcel, something like that. But actually postal departments handle many different things, such as it operates like a bank also. It don't give loan, but it is used for doing savings schemes, like savings bank, recurring deposit, fixed deposit kind of things. Okay, and also it handles insurance. Like just like LIC is there, right? So similar to that, in post office also there is insurance. It is called as postal life insurance or rural postal life insurance. Okay, and also it does many citizen-centric services. Citizen-centric services means public can go and avail many services, such as you can apply for now passport center is being done in post office. Aadhaar center is being handled at post office, and you can pay electricity bill, you can pay a telephone bill. So many things can be done at post office. So it is not just one thing. If you consider a courier service, it will do only parcels, letters, those things. If you consider bank, it will do only banking service, such as SBI if you are taking means, maybe they will be having loans, loan sections and all, but here loan sections will not be available, but the savings section will be available in post office. In the LIC, if you see, there will be insurance, but here here also insurance is available, but that's not the only thing which we are doing. Okay, and the citizen centric services, like we can see some computer centers doing this for people, right? So in post office also you can just go and avail that services. So if we may think like there is no letters being posted nowadays, everything is email and telephone is there, why we need of letters or parcels, right? So but actually there are nearly 500 crore letters or parcels being posted through India Post. Okay, mainly because official communications should happen through letters or parcels only, right? Maybe for Amazon or anything also, it is a parcel service. We can, as we are in city, we will get directly from Amazon delivery boys. But in the rural place, Amazon or Flipkart, they won't have any delivery boys, because there may be only few parcels or articles they will be getting for a specific location. Okay, so that's why they partner with India Post and they will send the letters, because India Post, if you use India Post, you will reach nook and corner of India. Okay, so and also like official communications means your PAN card, your ATM card, your Aadhaar card, and then your passports, everything if you request, you will get it through post only, right? They don't be it is not like only soft copy will be there, hard copy is also there, and for that purpose, and like a court communication and then business communications, tenders, for those kind of things, people will be sending post. Okay, so in post itself there are several products: register letters, speed post, parcels, register parcel, business parcel, cash on delivery parcel. Like that, many parcel systems are parcel and letter systems are available. So if we consider about insurance policy, there are around 4 crore insurance policies handled by India Post. Okay, so previously there was postal life insurance, like that one scheme is there, currently it is there. Previously it was allowed only for government employees. Now it has been open for any professionals like engineers, doctors, teachers, government employees. Okay, so like this insurance is being made available to many people, so that more and more people are coming into this. If you see the benefits, it will be more beneficial than your LIC policies also. Okay, and for banking, if you see, if we take SBI, there may be 17,000 or 18,000 branches all over India, because SBI is the largest bank in India, right? But post office in the city side alone, it will have around 10,000 offices, and in village side, all over covering the rural part, it will have around 140,000 offices will be there. So as the branch, if we consider, post office is having more branches than any other bank in India. Okay, and if you consider the number of accounts also, it will be more, but the transaction values is less than SBI maybe. Okay, and also like nowadays in postal account also you get internet banking, ATM cards, this phone pay, like Google Pay, we are having a service like Dark Pay, like that one app is there, with that you can use similar to Google Pay and all. Okay. Okay, so now I will tell you about where I am working. So Center for Excellence in Postal Technology is the software wing of Postal Department, right? So It was established in 2000. So when at that time, previously what happened before 2000, every transaction will be happening in notebook only. Okay, there were no computers. The postmaster will note down what you have did, how much you have deposited, how much you have withdrawn, and whenever you come again, he will take the note and check what happened. Okay, then what happened? The department decided to computerize the whole department. Okay, so computers were given, and then for that purpose, we CEPT only developed softwares for that, for our operations, such as the whatever you have seen, right? Three different major business we are having, like mails, and then savings bank, and then insurance. For all the business process software was developed by CEPT only. Okay, so that was called as Meghdoot package. So what was the issue with that software? Was it was not like online, it is like offline software. In that computer only it will be available, or in that office only it will be available. So whenever you want to withdraw some amount, you need to go to that specific office, then only you can deposit or withdraw your accounts. Okay, but the letters and all you can post anywhere. So because of this, what happened? Then later the department, forgot to say. So till today, these softwares, whatever we developed, Meghdoot softwares, are being used in some of the African countries, Bhutan and our neighboring countries and all, in their postal department. Okay, we are not doing it as a business, we are doing it as a service. We are giving the software for free for them so that they can use it. Okay, so what in 2012 the department decided to make the products online. For example, if you deposit in one post office, you can withdraw from any other post office in India. Okay, so for that purpose the projects were given to Infosys and TCS. So they developed the different softwares for different products. We are having mails, savings bank, and insurance, right? So Finacle is the thing which is developed, software developed by Infosys. It will be used for the banking operations. Okay, so this software is only used in several other banks also, like Indian Bank and all. You see, is using this software only. Okay, and for mails, the software is called as CSI, Core System Integrator. It was developed by TCS. It is done using SAP, SAP software is there, right? It is an ERP tool. So with the use of SAP, the TCS company has modified it for post office purpose, and then they have given the software to us for our day-to-day activities. Okay. Then Mechamesh is the software for insurance purpose, whatever I said, right? PLI and RPLI. For those things, Mechamesh is the software. It is developed by Infosys. Okay, so now this is also online. Finacle is also online. The latter thing, what is the advantage by using this online software for mail operations, that is letters? We can track the letters currently where it was. In previous software, it is not that much easy to track where the letters are, what happened to it. Okay, now because it is online, we get immediately the information about what happened to that article at each step. So what happened if you post a letter from Chennai to Delhi, let's say it will go to a sorting hub, and then from sorting hub it will go through a train or flight and then reach Delhi sorting hub, and from the Delhi sorting hub again they will sort and give it to the specific post office of that pin code. Okay, then the post office person will give it to postman, then the postman will deliver it to the customer in his doorstep. Okay, so these things, each step the software will take care. They will scan the articles each time. Whenever you can see, right, if an article or letter is coming, you will have a barcode on that letter. So using that only you can track the letter. So every place wherever the letter goes, like post office, then sorting hub, then again the sorting up in Delhi, and then the next post office, assigning to postman. So all these places the letter will be scanned. So each scan we will it will update the status of the letter, so that will be reflecting in our tracking. In India Post website there is an option to track the software, sorry, track the letter. Okay, so if you give that article number, the letter number which is available in the barcode, then it will tell what is the status, where, what happened, at what time, in which office, exactly everything the tracking system will tell us. Okay, so using, because of the Pinnacle software, what happened, so now people can deposit in any post office and withdraw it from any other post office in India. Also ATM ATM cards are issued. There are 1000 ATMs of India Post is available all over India. Okay, there you can use other bank cards also, ATM cards also, and post office ATM cards also. Similarly, post office ATM cards you can use in other banks ATMs also. So that is, that and all was possible because of using this Pinnacle software. Okay, similarly it will calculate the interest rates, and then it will take care of closure and those things and all, this software will take care. In Mekamish also it is like that, you can pay it anywhere in the country instead of paying in single office always. You can pay it anywhere, and here also online online payment and all you can make. All these were possible because of this software. And Darpan is a software, it is developed by Infosys and CPT together. So what it will do is, in buses you will see, right, that the conductor will be having some device. So similar to that, the rural post office postmaster, branch, we call them as branch postmaster, okay, they will be having a device similar to what our conductors are having. So it is called as RICT device, or for our Indian term we are using Darpan. Okay, so that software, what it will do, it will connect with all three software, this CSI, this Pinnacle and Mekamish. So whenever in rural India some person is doing a transaction, then data will get flowed into Pinnacle, CSI, Mekamish. For example, if I book a letter, that data will be pushed to CSI software from that device, Darpan device. Okay, if I pay an premium of insurance, that will be pushed to Mekamish software. Okay, and then if I want to withdraw some amount, so it will be connected to Pinnacle software and check whether I am having the balance or not, then it will allow me to take the amount. Okay, so these are the major softwares used in India Post currently. Okay, so when there is a shift, right, from in 2000s we created a Mentoo software and it was implemented in all the computers around India. So suddenly now we want to change to new software, right? So this there is a transition phase. So that was handled by CEPT. So whatever data previously it was there, that should come to the new software, new database. Right, previously it was in each and every computer. In each post office there will be computer, there the data was stored. So those things were taken and it was centralized and it was put into servers. Okay, then by one district we can say. So like that, all over India these new softwares were introduced. Okay, we will be starting with one pilot location. And then if it is successful, we will go to the next. If it is failed, we will correct it. Again, we will go for the pilot location. We will implement it. And then we will go to the next location. So like that, now almost all of the post offices in India are with this new software, except for those locations where internet facility is not available. You can think, like, because we are in a city, you can think whether any place in India is there without electricity, like that, but without internet, you can think. But places like northeast, like Nagaland, Assam, Manipur, those places are there, right? So there it is difficult to have the internet connection. Or even in Tamil Nadu there are places where the internet connectivity is a problem. Okay, so except for those places, all other places in India has been moved to this new software. So what are the other places, remaining places, they are still using this Meghdoot software, and we now made a provision to push the data from Meghdoot software to the new softwares, Pinnacle, TSI and Mechamish, so that it will not have any gap. If you book a article in Meghdoot software also, it will come to the CSI software somehow. They may be taking it in pen drive and putting it in the place where the network is available. So those kind of activities will be happening. Okay. So then apart from these major software, we do many websites, mobile applications, desktop applications. Okay, so I am part of the web development team and I have created desktop apps also. So why we do websites and all? We need to have reporting systems. Okay, so one of the important thing why a project is made online is so we can get the reports. If at all, if you say if everything was with no, note and pen only, if you want to find how much is the total collection today, what do you need to do? You need to calculate everything manually. Okay, for one day you can calculate. If I ask for 1 year, okay, at that time you need to take all the books and you need to sit down and spend hours to get at the value. So that is for single office. If you consider it for all India, how much time it will take to consolidate that data alone? Okay, so it will take days or months. Right, that too with a huge product base. We are having like more than 200-300 products will be there. Okay, in each product we need to check what happened, where it happened, how it happened, and then only we can take decisions for it. Right, how to improve the quality or what is lagging. To do all that we need reports. Okay, so one of the major thing why this online applications are being done is the data will be in a centralized server. So from there we can generate reports and take decisions immediately. We need not wait till everything is getting consolidated. Okay, so as in web team, I have created many reporting sites and then I have created some online. There are some internal examinations will be happening in India Post. So for that purpose, I have made like entire flow. A person can apply online and then he can, the higher official will approve his application. Then he will get a hall ticket and he can, along with his roll number generation and also the exam center. Okay, and then he will get the hall ticket and go and write the exam. So all this process was previously manually taking place. The people will write the application, send by post to the higher official. Okay, then they will send reply along with their hall ticket. So these process and all, I made a website with that. Now it is automated. Like people can apply online, the actions will be taken online, and hall ticket generation will be online. Only the candidate should download and go and write the exam. Okay, just like how we apply any exams, maybe now you are in second year, right? So when you go to fourth year or in the final semester, you will be applying to some companies. So that similar to that website, it can be taken. Okay. Also, we during the pandemic time, we have developed one website where people can request for service from their home itself. They will just submit their request, like I want money from my account. So the postman will go to their home based on the request. The postman will go to their home and then ask their what is their need, and then he will serve it. If he wants money, he will come back and check whether his account is having money, and then he will do that. Also, we are doing many mobile applications nowadays. Postmen's are carrying mobiles. Okay, so with the mobile we are having one app developed at CEPT. So using that app only, postman will be delivering the articles. Previously it was postman will be having a paper, he will have the address of the recipient. So he will go to the each places with the address. Now it is not like that. Now the postman will have all the details in the mobile, in his app. There only he will see each person's address, and he will go there and deliver the letter, and he will update the status immediately in the mobile app itself. So if you check the tracking, immediately it will be updated, like your article is delivered, like that. Okay, so like that we are having another app, Post Info. So it will give you information like what is the interest rate, what is the pin code of a particular area. If you know the pin code but you don't know the office name, means you can enter the pin code and you can get the office name and the location of the office. It will give you the route. Okay, those kind of things, like a premium calculator. I told right, there is a insurance section. So there also you can find out how much premium you should pay for a particular insurance, and you can pay online through that app also. Okay, so these kind of apps are also being developed by CEPT. So these things are done not by TCS or Infosys. We are doing it in-house. In-house means CEPT is only doing it. Okay, so also CEPT has a data recovery center. So here it is huge data, right? All over India, all transactions are happening. Daily there may be some, if you consider, it will be like some 5 crore to 10 crore records will be there added in each product totally. Considering all products, we will get around some 10 crore records, let's say. So post office is working for 6 days also throughout the year. Saturday also post office is working. So if you consider for a year, the data will be very, very huge. Okay. So our main data center is in Mumbai. So CEPT Mysore is having the data recovery center. Each minute the sync will be happening from the main server to data recovery center. Data will be flowing each minute. Okay, so whatever has happened in main server, the copy of that will be available in the data recovery center. In case anything happened to the data center, main data center, immediately the data recovery center will be up. Instead of data flowing to data center, the data will be coming to data recovery center. Okay. So any doubts till now? Anything in our operations you want to ask me, you can ask. I'll wait. Hold on for some seconds or minutes. You can type in chat box or you can talk also. No doubts. So whether you people have went to post office before, you are having any postal account or anything? Then I will continue with the topic. Okay. So this is the brief about the India Post and our CEPT, Center for Excellence in Postal Technology. Okay, so now I will start with the main topic. So what is the program? So I want the session to be interactive so someone can answer. What is the program? based on your understanding, you can say, I don't want full definitions and all. Yeah, please see.
Hi guys, I will be reviewing it and I will give the zero line up for your part. You are going to be the two order. Fine, you can be one among the first one.
Students, mute yourself.
Any other answer? Okay, whether your program will control the software or it will control the hardware. You are writing program to control the software or to control the hardware? Instruction is for software instruction, we can say, but what it is doing internally, if you are saying you are creating a calculator software, okay, so what it will do, you are saying 5 plus 5, it is giving the answer 10, right, where the operation is happening, in the app or in the hardware? The 5 plus 5, 10, that operation is happening in your software or it is happening in the RAM or hard disk or where? It's okay, if it is wrong also you can tell, no issues. Yes, hardware. Okay, so this instruction, because if you are just having a software, will the software work? It should be installed in some machine, right? Either in a computer or in a mobile phone. Somewhere it should be installed. Then only the software will work. Because we are giving instructions to hardware. The program what we are doing, it is like instructions to the hardware. Most of the time. Sometimes you may give for another software also. Like from one software, we can get input from other software or pass output to other software. That can happen. But primary operation will be taking place in hardware. That is our processor. Okay. So, the Program, this is not a full definition, we can say. It is just for understanding purpose I have given. So a program is set of instruction to implement computerization of any activity done manually or an imagination. Okay, so before you may be doing 5 plus 5 in your notebook or in your mind. Right, so instead of that you are writing a code to do that activity. Okay, so whatever I told, the application form what have been sent to the higher officials manually. Now that has been computerized. Okay, so for the banks or post office, everything was working before computers were introduced also. But they were doing the operations manually. But now it is computerized. So most of our softwares, what it is doing, it is changing the physical activity to computerized activity, or our imaginations we are implementing. Just like games are there, right? It is our imaginations. It is not real. Our imaginations we are implementing through the code. Okay, so this is not definition. I am saying you, it is for understanding purpose I have given this. Okay, so then okay. That is a program. So what is the software? Whether program and software is same or different? Same. Whether in all cases it is same or in specific case it is same. Then why do we say it program and that as software? We can say it as software only, no? One term is enough, no? If it is same. Software also contains documentation, instruction that tells the computer what to do. Now that is what we told for program also, instruction that tells the computer what to do. Set of programs or softwares. Yes, right. So a group of programs, okay, linked programs, not like something random programs together. If you put it, it will not be a software. It is a package, we can say, package of programs to do a single task or set of tasks. There may be cases where single program will act as a software. Okay, but that is not true in all cases. Mostly software will be containing more than one program. It will be a package of related programs. Okay, so it may consist of database. A program need not contain database. Okay, but software means mostly it will have some database. It wants to store something and tell you, give you back something, or it can at least do multiple operations. Okay, but a program need not be like that. A program can be simply whatever writing, print 1 to 100, that is also a program. Okay, but print 1 to 100, if you say as a software, maybe 30-40 years back, it may be accepted. But now, what is the use of that software? Okay, so software means for some specific purpose or task, we are creating the software. It should have the purpose, a need, everything. And for that need, the programs will be packed together. It will be linked from one screen to another screen. For example, you may be registering, for example, Instagram or Facebook, if you take, or WhatsApp, you are registering for the first time, right? So that is one program. Registration is one program. Okay, and then login is another program. So these two are linked. If you register only, the login will work. If you did not register, login will not work. Okay. And then once you go inside, after login, what is happening? That is also linked with the details you have given during the registration. Okay, if you are male, it will give you different notifications or suggestions. If you are female, it will give different notifications or suggestions. If you are engaged, it may give different options. If you are old age, it will give you different suggestions. Okay, so everything is related. Suddenly something which is not related, I cannot have it in a software. It will be meaningless. Okay, so software, whatever apps you are using, whether it is having documentation inside as for a user. Someone was answering like software means it will have documentation. For that purpose I'm asking. So whether software as a user you have seen documentation, or whether we are using documentation. Okay, mostly there won't be any documentation kind of thing. For the company purpose, they will be having. Who is the developer, the developing company, they will be having documentation. Okay, but the software will be having some instructions for users maybe, not the documentation. It may say help instructions can be there, or what are the features available to tell that some menu will be given. Okay, so that's all it will be there. It won't consist of documentation. And it doesn't mean that for every software, documentation will be surely there. If you are creating a software, you know everything in mind means you will not be documenting it. You will just create the software and release. Okay, that is not a good practice, but it can happen. There is no restriction that if documentation is there only, software should be available like that. There is no restriction. You can do softwares, release it without documentation also, or with documentation also you can do. It's users' convenience, we can say. Okay, but it is not at all a good practice to do the software without documentation. Okay, so we will see what is documentation and what are the benefits and what are the disadvantages, everything. Okay. So before we start to develop our software, it becomes quite essential for us to understand and document the exact requirements of the customer. You may be doing it for yourself or for the customer. Okay. So if you are doing it for yourself or for the customer, you should understand what are the requirements. Like why this software is being done. What will be the input? What will be the output? Okay. So everything in computer, it's going to take one input and give some output, right? So for each software also there will be input and output. So those things should be decided as requirements. So experienced members of the development team carry out this job. They are called as system analyst. The following basic questions pertains to the project to the project should be clearly understood by the analyst in order to obtain good grasp of the problem. So if you are going to create the software, first you should answer these questions. You should know the answer of the questions, then only you should start developing the software. Okay, so what are those questions? What is the problem? Okay, so in the post office scenario, I told, right, previously a customer can deposit or withdraw in only one place, one post office. Wherever he opened the account, there only he can deposit, there only he can withdraw. That was the case. So that is a problem. Because I will be traveling, we cannot restrict people like, if you are here only, you should do. Like that, we should not restrict. Okay. So that is a problem previously. For that purpose, now we want to solve the problem. Like, I want to deposit anywhere, withdraw anywhere. So that is what I want. So why it is important to solve the problem? Why it is important? We can say no. Let the customer be in one place. Let him deposit there only, withdraw there only. Like that we can say. But as we are valuing our customers, we need to give them options or features, facilities. Okay, so that he will not be like in a restricted way. He can be free. Because he is the customer, we should not instruct him what or restrict him, he should do this, do that. Okay, so to facilitate customer, we want to give this solution to the customer. Like he can deposit anywhere, he can withdraw anywhere. That is the solution. Okay, so what are the possible solutions to the problem? So we can analyze it before the development of software. They might have analyzed how we can solve this problem, whether we should create a website to solve this problem, or we have to daily take the data and at the evening send it to server. Okay, let the desktop app be there, internet is not required, only at the end of the day, after every transaction is over, we can send the transaction to server. Like that, the one solution can be given. Or live only, all transactions should be updated, like a website. So that is another solution. Okay, similarly, we can say 5-6 solutions if you want, if you analyze. Okay, that we should first know, what are the different solutions available. Okay, and what exactly are the, because if we know the different solutions only, we can come to a conclusion which solution we will choose. So what exactly are the data inputs to the system and what exactly are the data outputs by the system. So here inputs will be the account number of the customer, the date of transaction, the amount of deposit or withdraw. Okay, so that will be the input, and output should be success or failure, whether the system updated the balance. For example, I am having 100 rupees. So if I go to post office and if I am having 1000 rupees, let's say, I am going to post office and tell I want 100 rupees. So if I give my account number, the date and 100 rupees, it should go to the system server and update it and then give me back success. The withdrawal transaction has been entered in the database. Okay, if it is success only, I can give the amount to the, I can receive the amount from the post office. If it is failure, due to some reason, for example, network may not be there, or the account itself is not available, I am giving some dummy account. Okay, if in that case, the transaction will not happen. If it is failure, I should not give the, get the money. Okay, so that is what input and output, we should take the decision of that, what is the input, what is the output. So what are likely complexities that might arise while solving the problem? Okay, so now I want to create the software, I decided, but what are the problems I will face? As I told, all the computers are individual computers. Now the main problem is taking all the data and putting it in a place in the central server and start doing the transaction. It will not happen overnight. It's not like one day we will take and put it, because post office will be keep on operating. Okay, and in one by one place only we are doing, for first in Chennai district, then in Kanchipuram district, then in Tiruvallur district, like that we will be doing. Okay, so we cannot say like, okay, today from here until I create the software, post office will not work for 1 year, like that we cannot say. Okay, so those are the complexities. So how to handle it and all, we should think. So if there are external softwares or hardware with which the developed software has to interface, then what exactly would be the data interchange format with the external system? So for example, I told in a letters example, I told scanners will be there. The operators will be scanning the articles. Okay. So that is a scanner, is an external device. Okay. So that external device, how the data will be pushed to the software? Whether it will be in number format, or it will be in text format, or it will be in some other binary format. Okay, those kind of details should be decided previously itself, before developing the software. So before developing the software, these are the questions to be answered. Okay. So next step. So SRS document, mainly there are three parts: functional requirements of the system, non-functional requirements of the system, and goals of implementation. Okay, so we will see this in detail one by one. Okay, so these are the elements. Those three are main parts of the document. So these are all the overall elements of the SRS document. So first we should find out what is the purpose of the software being developed. Okay, so if there is a correct purpose only, the software will be useful. Without that, without any purpose, if we are having the software, it will not be useful, right? One second. Then the overall description of the software. We should tell the overall description. For example, in the Pinnacle software, they will be having the overall description as a online system which will take care of the transactions happening all over India and having it in a centralized database, which can be retrieved by any of the post offices in India or ATMs in India. Okay, so this is an example, just I'm saying. Okay, like this, we should have the overall idea of what the software will be doing. Then the functionality of the software or what it is supposed to do. Okay, so what are the functionalities of this software? If we see that banking software example, it should have the option to create a new account. It should have option to have a deposit, withdrawal, all those things. It should have option to close the account. It should have option to transfer the account from one office to another office. Okay, then it should have account to option to automatically in year end the interest will be calculated and given to each account. Okay, that detail should be, that thing should be there in the software. Option should option should be there in the software to calculate the interest rates, all those things. Okay, and then user management. The user should be able to log in, because post office, it should not be open software. Anyone can go and do like that, it will not be there. So user creation should be there, user deletion should be there. User will move from one post office to another post office. So that should be handled. User may change his password. That should be handled. If he forgets his password, what to do next? Okay, and whether for high value transaction, whether one person if he is doing, whether it is enough. Because for example, in post office, what happens, you know, the person who is working in the counter, he will do the transaction. Then there will be a supervisor. He will authorize the transaction. If for example, if you are taking 10,000 rupees, first you will give to the counter person. Counter person will enter it in the system. Then the supervisor will authorize it. Then only you can get the amount. Because to avoid frauds. Okay, so these kind of functionalities should be available in the software. That should be documented first. What and all functionalities is needed in the software. Okay, then performance of the software in production situation. In the design phase itself, we should know how many users will be there, how many accounts will be there, or at least the projected growth should be there. For example, post office means 155,000 post office, we told. So at least 155,000 users will be there. Right, and accounts we are having, as I told, 34 crores accounts are there. So it may be growing. So in each year, if it grows 5 crore, then what will be the projected growth in 10 years? So after 10 years also, whether the software can handle this or not. Okay, so with that idea only the software should be developed. It should not be like today I have 100 customers, so I will do software for 100 persons. Okay, tomorrow if suddenly one more 10 persons is getting added, our software should not say, no, I won't allow. This software is made for 100 persons only. Okay, like that it should not be there. So we should worry about the performance also. And if 1 lakh people are using, then also the speed should be good for everyone. No issue should come. Okay, so those things and all should be documented previously in the SRS document itself. Then non-functional requirements. Non-functional requirements are such as the speed of the software, how much it should be, accuracy. This and all will not be told. Like interest calculation should happen correctly, like that in the requirement they will not say. They will say interest calculation should happen. Okay, but as a non-functional requirement, we need to mention that interest calculation should act work perfectly. Okay, then the how much capacity system should be there? Okay, like whether it is 4 GB RAM computer is enough, or whether computer itself is not needed, mobile phone is enough. Okay, these are all non-functional requirements. As the user, they may not worry about that initially. Then after we do a software, and if we say no, you need to have Apple iPhone only, then only your software will work, or a MacBook only, then only your software will work, means then it is of no use, right? So we should know what the user is having, and we should previously tell this software will work in 4 GB RAM Windows computer. Okay, then we can, if you document it, then no problem. After completing the product, we should not say the requirement. So here functional requirement should also be mentioned in the document. Then external interfaces, or how the software will interact with hardware or other softwares it must connect to. Okay, so as I told, the RICT device, it will know Darpan, it will connect with different software like CBS, the CSI and Mechamish and all. So those kind of things, how it will interact, in what format it will interact. Okay, so those kind of details should also be documented. For example, data will be sent in JSON format, or data will be sent in text format, or daily some Excel file will be kept. Those kind of things will be mentioned in this space, in this part, okay, part of the SRS document. Then design constraints or limitations of environment that the software will run in. So it's like, as I told previously, that it will be there, it we told as requirements. Here we can say that as limitations. It will work in only Windows computer. You cannot expect beyond that. Or we can say like it up to 2 lakh users, it will work perfectly. So after that, you cannot expect more. So like this, constraints we can say before itself in the SRS document, so that the user will not try beyond that and complain later. Okay, he will say like, you did not say itself whether after 2 lakh customer, 2 lakh users, it will stop working. Okay, so like that and all, we need to say before itself in the SRS document. Okay, so properties of good SRS document. So what the SRS document should have? So concise means it should be short and clear to the point. It should not be like pages and pages, like 300-400 pages. If it is going, no one will even read it. Okay, so it should be short and clear to the point. What is required, that only should be there. No unwanted stuff should be there in the document. Then it should be structured. It should have table of contents, and then it should have sub points, points. All the things should be there. If you see a book, how it will be similar to that, the document should be. Then only immediately someone opens, he wants to check it, he can go to a specific point and read that alone if he wants. Maybe the user will be having different teams to check the document also, we don't know. So one team may check the system specification, one team may check the functionality, okay, one team may check the non-functional requirements, like that it may be there. So if it is structured, they can immediately go to the specific required points. If it is not structured, just like paragraph you are writing, they cannot find out where the things are. Okay, so it should be structured. Then black box view. Black box view means, even if they don't know anything technically, they should understand the document. Okay, that is black box view. Because mostly the persons who is seeing the document, they may not be a developer. They may be from management people only. Management only will decide, right? So mostly they may not be even technical. So our document should be in such a simple English or most understandable language that even if we doesn't know anything about computer, programming language, database, anything you don't know also, you should understand the document. Okay, that is the black box view. Then conceptual integrity. Conceptual integrity means in the document you need not, you should not tell about the some business details. Okay, what concept you are using? For example, for tariff calculation, you are using some formula that should not be given in the or interest calculation. Some formula you are using. Let's say, for in case of India Post, it is open, but in some other company, some secrets may be there, or that and all should not be available in the document. Just like you are saying, I want to document it. You should not tell all the steps. Okay, I will take A as input. I will multiply with 100. I will get divided by 3.4. Something like that. You should not keep on telling the steps and all. Okay, the concept should be as a user view only. The document should be there, not the technical details. Okay. Technical details means as the programmer, what you see, the technical things, that should not be given in the document. Okay, so response to undesired events. Response to undesired events means, so as I told, we are having a data recovery center. Right, so if any event happened, for example, some earthquake happened or some tsunami happened, what the system should do? Okay, so that details, and suddenly power off is happening in between middle of the transaction. How the system will handle it? Whether it will commit and roll back those things. For example, you are going to ATM, you are entering the password, and when the amount is coming, power is gone. What will happen? Okay, so that things and all should be told in the document. For undesired events also, how it will be handled. Okay, so if a good SRS document means it will have these all properties, only then it will be considered as a good SRS document. We can also create one page document and give it, this is my SRS document, but that will be of no use. Okay, so we should make sure that our document is having all these points clearly. Then another thing is, it should be verifiable. Verifiable means it should be point by point. If you are saying 10 functionalities, then the person who is going to check, he should be able to verify it. Okay, point 1 is completed, point 2 is completed, point 3 is completed, like that he can do. If it is as I told, like if it is not structured and it is having paragraphs, he cannot verify it. For example, you can say like, okay, functionality 1, login page, functionality 2, registration, functionality 3, DB backup, something like that. If you are having those things, he will say, okay, done, like that. He will tick it and go to next point. So our document should be in that way. So this is an example table of contents of SRS document. Okay, so our table of contents, our document should have table of contents similar to this. It need not be exactly the same. All SRS document, we cannot say like everyone will use same format and all. But the main features should be, the main requirement should be covered in the document. Okay. So introduction should be there, purpose of the software, intended audience. Intended audience means who is going to use or benefit from it. Intended use, why it should be used. For banking means only for banking it should be used. It should not be used for insurance or mail. Scope, definitions, we might have used some terms or some abbreviations. So those details can be given in the definitions. Okay, overall description, user needs. This user needs is very important, because for user only you are creating the software. You should not do a software which the user doesn't need. Okay, you should not give some feature which he doesn't need at all. Okay. For example, in the banking system, you need not have any chat option or anything. That is not required. Okay, so user need should be first captured and documented properly. Then only it will be, those needs can be met. One by one you can meet the needs and finally you can bring a software fully. Okay, and then assumption and dependencies. Assumption and dependencies mean sometimes we assume data is already there. Okay, so that is an assumption. Or power is already there. Because if power is there only, everything will work right. The computer is there, but if there is no power, what will happen? It is of no use. Right, so the power thing should be handled by the office itself. So that is not the work of the software developer. So those things and all can be an assumption. Just I am saying as an example. So like this, we can assume predefined things. And dependencies. Dependencies means like it should have Windows OS as a dependency. It should have RAM of this much capacity as a dependency. It should have a browser. If it is an online online application, the user should have the browser. That is a dependency. Without browser, he cannot open the online application itself. Right. Then system features and requirements. So this is the important part where the functionalities will be given. So functional requirements, external interface requirements, system features, non-functional requirements. Okay. So these things should be given in the system features and requirements. Then limitations and also budget and timeline. This is also important because for any software to be developed, there should be a timeline. If it is 3 months, it should be done in 3 months. If you are taking the input and doing the software after 5 years, what is the use? Okay, so the timeline also should be mentioned in the document. Also budget. This software will cost this many thousand or lakhs or crores, whatever it is, it should be given in the document. After doing, you should not say, okay, you should pay me some 500 crores for this. Like that, you should not say. So the budget also should be part of the SRS document, budget and timeline. Timeline means phase by phase, we can say, okay, first 5 functionality will be done in 3 months. Second 5 functionality will be done in the 4th, 5th, 6th month. Last functionality will be done in the 8th month. Okay, implementation will happen either once the first part is done or after all the parts are done. Okay, like that, based on the decisions, we should make the implementation. Then testing, when it will happen. Those kind of things should be given in the timeline. Okay, so, okay, next we will see problems without a SRS document. If SRS document is not available, what is the problem? I can still develop the software, right? Why SRS document is required? Yeah, now someone can tell me why this SRS document is important or documentation is important. If it is not there, what is the problem? Because as I told in the beginning, without document also you can create the software. But why it is important? What problem we will be facing if there is no document? You can guess also. Yeah, because instead of SRS, if I say just by words, then also you can do the software, right? It is a basis. Who is deciding it is the base? It is our decision, the programmer decision and the customer decision. But as a programmer, why we should insist on SRS or the documentation? We should insist as a developer or a programmer, we should insist for documentation. So what problems we will face if there is no documentation? No problem. Okay, let us see what are the problems we have. So if the project needs, first of all, if the needs and other things are not documented, what will happen is the customer will keep on changing their needs. Okay, he will go today, first he will tell, okay, I need a login page with these details or registration page with these details. Okay, after that he will start developing. Then what will happen? After 1 month he will see some other things, or he will keep on thinking about that, and then he will come up and say, no, I don't want in this fashion, I want in different fashion. Instead of 5 details, I want 10 details in the registration page. Okay. So the customer will keep on changing the needs. That will be a big problem. As a developer, I have faced this problem many times. Okay. So because ours in we are doing the internal project, right? Like our higher officials will tell to create a website. Then suddenly tomorrow they will change some of the needs. So then we need to change in the database, we need to change in the design, everywhere changes will happen. It is very, very difficult for the developer. Okay, if it is a customer, what will happen? You cannot say as it is, you cannot, whatever you did in 1 month, if he suddenly changes all the things, you cannot claim that you did that 1 month work. He may think after that, okay, I have registration page. So registration page means it should, whatever I say finally, that is only registration page. If you do something which is not required by me, previously it was required, now it is not required, means the customer say, no, that is not considered as a work. Okay, so then it will be a problem. So because the customer should not keep on changing the needs, we should first document it. Then we can say that, see, previously 1 month back you told these are the needs. Now if you are changing, I cannot do anything. Or for that you should do the extra payment. Those kind of things will come into picture. Without developing the SRS document, the system would not be implemented according to the customer needs. So for customer purpose also, if everything is documented, then the all needs will be satisfied one by one. If you are just hearing, okay, you tell me 10 needs, I will do the software. What happened in the process, in 1 or 2 months, we will forget about what he told. 1 or 2 points we will forget. Okay. Then what will happen? The software will not come out fully. So in order to make sure that all the customer needs are met, we should document the needs. So it should be, it will be in the SRS document only, right? So then software developer would not know whether what they are developing is what exactly required by the customers. If document is not there, mostly what will happen, the developer will not go to the customer and get the document, right? There will be some manager or someone who will go to the customer and talk and then get the project, get the document. Okay, if the document itself is not there, the developer will not know exactly what the customer needs. Manager's terms may be different. He may tell it in different way, but what the customer wanted will be different. Okay, that confusions and all will happen if the document is not there. Okay, then without SRS document, it will be very much difficult for the maintenance engineer to understand the functionality of the system. So once the developer is done, if he is, let's say, he changed to some other company, or he has got promotion, some other person is working under in that role, okay, so our the maintenance team is different. Okay, in that time what will happen, the person who is maintaining, he cannot understand why the software was done, what it is doing, what are the options available. Okay, sometimes some options may be inbuilt, but if it is not documented properly, the person will not know that option is there or not itself. He may sometime be doing it again, or he may be doing it in different way which is not required, wasting time. Okay, so that's why this SRS document is important. And it will be very much difficult for user document writers to write the user manual properly without understanding the SRS document. If the SRS document is there only, the software will be developed based on that. And the user document writer, usually the software developer may not write the manual for the user, someone else will do. Okay, so that someone else will cannot compare. If document is not there, whatever is available in software, he will try to understand something, he will write his own words, whatever he wants. But if this document is there, he will compare the document and the software and then write the user manual. Also, for a testing person also, this SRS document will be helpful. Okay, he can check, okay, these are the functionalities required, whether everything is done correctly. These are the inputs we need to give, whether this inputs it is accepting correctly. This is the expected output, whether that output is coming correctly. Everything you can check based on the SRS document. Okay, so without SRS document, these are all the major problems. So we should always insist to have the documentation before and after, like manual preparation is also very much important. And architects or the system analyst experts, they say like how much ever we give time for development, that much time we need to give for documentation also. The SRS document, the manual, okay, everything, the sequence diagrams, the database design. So for the documentation also, we need to give same amount of time. If you are saying 3 months for development, 3 months should be given for the document preparation also. Okay, so in our real life scenario, what is happening, you know, whenever we face some issue in the software, the Spinnaker, Mechamish and CSI, what happens if we ask the customers, we are the customers actually, right? India Post is the customer to TCS, Infosys in those three projects. So as a customer, if we ask something, why this is not correct, what they will say? No, they will say this was given in the document, or you bring the document, then we will talk. Okay, so that much important the document is having. If it is in a document and they have not implemented, means they will immediately do it. If it is not in the document, and if you want to say some, because it is now 5 years or 10 years happened after 2012, now it is 9 years. So in this time, almost many new things may come. Like API and all was not popular at that time, but now here, nowadays APIs are very popular. Okay, so if you wanted to say them like, we want to implement API, they will say like, it is not in the document, you need to pay us more for creating API. Okay, so like that, if we are having futuristic thinking, then it will be better. In the documentation itself, we can mention that in future we may require this thing, then they cannot say no for that. Okay, and whenever some problem occurs, this document only will be checked, whether this problem is based on the software development or based on the requirements given. Okay. Okay. So any questions? Any doubts till now? Any doubts? Everyone understood? First of all, we understand, only doubts will come now. Doubt about India Post or CPT or this SRS document, anything you can ask. or about web development also you can ask. Okay. So I think no one has doubts. So I will take another 10 minutes. I am having another slide. Just it's like what you should do for your career growth, like that. I wanted to have one slide. Okay. I think I will not take much time for this. Okay, so now you are all in second year, right? So and you are in lockdown also now. So if you spend at least 1 hour per day in any of the thing, whichever you want to succeed, okay, you can before you complete your college, you will get 730 hours daily, 1 hour if you take. So in that you can surely succeed. Maybe you can for development you can study technologies, or for any examinations you can prepare for your higher studies like GATE or TOEFL or whatever. So whatever, you spend at least 1 hour for that. Okay. Because consistency is what matters. All those people who are smart are not successful. We cannot say like, okay, he is very smart, he is successful. But all the persons who are consistent, they will be surely successful. Okay, so consistency is the key. Whatever you do, if you do something for 15 minutes daily, do that for 15 minutes daily. Don't do for 1 day, 10 hours and 1 month nothing. Okay, like that don't do. And then now itself you can create your LinkedIn account. How many of you are having already LinkedIn accounts? I don't know. So if you are not having, you can create. So it is like a professional social media, you can say. So you can follow the persons who are working in big companies. They may be sometime posting about job notifications, what is going on in their company, your dream companies, you can follow there. Okay. So at least once in a while you log in there, you update your skills. So what will happen when they are searching for someone? Okay, at that time the LinkedIn will shortlist your profile and show to them. Okay, so once you learn a skill, you update there in the LinkedIn. Okay, it will be very useful for your career. And also create a GitHub account. So GitHub is like a online repository where people post their open source projects. So if you have that, you can also create your account and you can do some small projects and upload there. So in companies, what they do, no, they usually post, because a big team will be working, they need to share the code. Okay, one person will be doing login, one person will be doing the registration page, one person will be doing the transaction page. Okay, but that should be put together. So they will be using GitHub for doing that. Okay, so that what they will do, one person will make the login and upload there, one person will do the registration and upload there. Then at the end it will be like a whole project. So whenever you want to do small change also, you can do your part and upload there. So this is the common practice in companies and all. So if you learn that now, and your projects are there in the GitHub, it will be showing how many people downloaded your project. So if your project is very famous, and then the companies will see your profile differently. Instead of a person who has not done any projects at all, if you do some projects and upload in the GitHub and some people have downloaded it, okay, then your profile will have some weightage. Also the company will think, okay, this person already knows GitHub, so I need not train him on that again. So that is also an added advantage. Okay, so if you want to be successful, do what the 99% don't do. If you want to be in top 1%, you should do what the 99% don't do, right? So wake up early, read books, always don't sit with the social media or YouTube, okay, other things. At least 1 hour per day you do those things, and wake up early. because morning no disturbances will be there. We will not go to social media as much because all those people using social media will be doing late nights and sleeping in the morning. Okay. Also, in improve your financial IQ. Just if you are learning, earning money is art. How to manage that money is also an art. Okay, we can take in the example of Anil Ambani and Mukesh Ambani. They were given equal amount of property. Okay, now one person is very much rich, another person, what happened, you know. Okay, so if money is there alone, it is not enough. How to handle that money, that knowledge is important. So you improve your financial IQ also. Okay, so that's this is my contact information. You can contact me anytime through my phone or email, or this is my LinkedIn profile is also there. Okay, so I think I'm done. If you want to ask anything, you can ask. Okay, then hope you might have noted it down. So thank you. Hope this session helps you for understanding some part at least.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
On behalf of the management, and the staff, I thank you for accepting our advice and sparing your time with us. We are really enlightened with your knowledge on SRS. It was great hearing from you about the connect with the postal department and engineering, how SEPT plays a role in generating postal software. I'm thankful to our management, principal sir, HOD sir, our year coordinator sir, for giving us the opportunity. A special thanks to the organizer, Mrs. Tamilarasi. Heartfelt thanks to all our students for the active participation. Thank you all. Thank you so much, sir. It was great hearing from you. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Students, kindly wait. I will be sharing you the attendance link as well as the feedback link. So today you will be receiving two links. So kindly fill both the Google forms, right? Students, please see to that you fill both the forms, both the links. One is for attendance, as you do every day, and the other one is the feedback link for this session. Okay, kindly make a note of that.
Yeah, madam, later you can share me the feedback form so I can also see that.
Sure.
Yeah.
Students kindly stay muted. Praveen sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Praveen sir. Okay, sir. Thank you for joining. Thank you so much for your patience. Thanks for waiting. Sir, shall I end the session, sir?
Yes, ma'am. You can end the session. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for the wonderful time. Thank you.